everybody. You're watching Mr. Fugu Data Science. We're going to do some ggplot2 basics today. Here's some of the sales data that we will be dealing with. Description, quantity, unit price, those will be combined to make a separate column called total price or total sales and countries. We will take the countries with their combined sales, create a plot, as well as taking the top 12 items that were sold with their sales totals. Think of ggplot taking in data frames, whereas base-R utilizes vectors for plotting, and you're using layers with ggplot, which is a distinction. You initialize your plot by calling ggplot, and you map your variables with something called an aesthetic labeled AES, which is your mapper for the variables. And instead of usually calling your data frame with the dollar sign and variable name, you'll just call the variable name that you're mapping. You also have things that are called themes, and a theme is basically dealing with anything else that's not your data that you're trying to map or plot. And you'll see that shortly. So let's get our first bit of data that we're going to deal with. Let's call in what we're going to map for our X and Y, which would be the description and our sales total. We scroll down and you see this is blank and it looks kind of small. So there's a few things that we're going to need to also do. And this X label looks really atrocious. So let's work piece by piece. First thing we need to do is figure out now how do we fix this so it's not barren. So let's copy this. Let's paste it in. And now we have to add something in, so you just use a plus. And ggplot doesn't know what you're trying to plot. Are you trying to plot a bar chart, a histogram, a scatter plot, nested plots? You have to actually tell it. And that's where you're basically creating each layer. So now we got our points. So this is looking a little promising. And before any trolls in the distant future, far, far and away from now, try to give me trouble because I'm doing a scatter plot currently, I will do a bar chart considering we're going to deal with categorical variables that are down here, okay? Instead of something that was like discrete, for instance. So don't give me a heartache. I'm just showing this for illustrative purposes. Now, since we're adding some layers, let's increase the size of this plot so it could be a little better in terms of illustrative purposes and basically allowing us to see what's going on, make it more legible. So you have to call this thing called options, where we're going to change the width. I arbitrarily decided this earlier, and then I'm going to also call in the height as well and change that. So let's see what this looks like. So it looks bigger, right? We can make this, that's the height, so. See, it's getting wider. So it's looking a little bit better if you see this representation of the plot width. Now, what else can we do with this to make it a little better? We need to size up our labels for one. The ticker, we need to make those bigger on the y-axis. Figure out how to achieve something with this x-axis so it's actually legible. So let's do that step by step, okay? So to increase the label sizes, let's do that now. And if you notice, everything else from above is just staying the same. We're just chaining everything together with a plus sign. So to increase our labels, we're going to use our first little theme. And I'm going to call in my axis text where we say it equals the element text. And I'm going to change the size of this to 14 so we can see this. And what other option do I have here? I'm going to call it bold. And there we are. So I forgot also the axis title. We're going to use our little element friend, element text. And then let's make that equal to 14 as well. And let's call the face equals bold again. So you can see that these are now bold. And you'll see that these are increased in size. And this is still illegible, which is wonderful. But we're getting close to what we need. So this changed this ticker here for the X axis and threw them at an angle so we can actually read this. So let's do another theme where we're taking the axis text of X and we're going to change the angle of it. I decided for this example, the angle of 7 looks good, and I'm doing a height adjustment of 1, and I'll explain shortly what it means when you do an H-just. So now we got it adjusted at an angle so it makes sense. So we're doing pretty good. We still need a title, which would make this a little more appropriate so we understand what we're looking at. Probably consider changing this label on the y-axis too, so it looks a little more professional. Okay, if you wanted, you could increase the size of this too. I alias this with gscat from what we just did, so I don't have to basically copy, cut, and paste anything. And when you're dealing with the H adjustment that I said I would explain, think of using this to shift from left to right horizontally, all right? So let's deal with title and subtitle. So I'm going to call something called labs for labels, and let's call in our title, and I'm going to call that sales by top 12 items. And then I'm going to also have a subtitle, which will be by description name. And then I need to also call on something else. I need to now, let's look at this and you'll see why. So you see that it's on the left-hand side. So we need to shift it over and center it. We could consider changing the color or increasing the size. So let's deal with this right now. Let's use our trusty old theme once again. And I'm going to say plot.title and then a little element, text. And what do I do with this? I want to change the color of my text for my title, and I'm going to arbitrarily just make it red, okay? I'm going to increase the size of this as well as make it bold. And I'm going to also adjust the horizontal direction to center this. What else can we do with this? We can play with the plot subtitle now and do basically the same thing, except I'm going to adjust it a little bit. And I'm going to call this one 16 instead. And instead of having it red, let's just make it blue for no real reason. So now we're centered. We have it increased in size and changed colors. So we're doing pretty good. What else can we do? We could also change these y-axis labels or ticks so it's not so big. If we want to do that, we could even adjust any of the range values. We could also do some highlighting on the axis. So let's do that. So let's think about how we're going to play with this. Let's call in our theme, and we're going to do an axis line. And that axis line will have, what is it? It's going to have our element, but this time it's a line. And this axis line will have a color equal to trusty old red, but it's going to have a really small size of 2. And that's where you can do a little customizing and make this pop. You don't need to do a red, of course, but I just wanted to illustrate that you can do this. What else can we do? Change that scaling of the y-axis. And there's a lot going on here. So let's do something real quick. So we need to figure out how we're going to scale this. So we're starting at 30,000. That's our lowest value. And we're over 120. So this is probably 130 or 140. And so since we have an idea, let's figure out how we're going to break this up. So I'm going to start at 30,000 for my lowest value. I'm going to go up to 135,000 and I'm going to increment by 15,000. But what else do I need? Well, there's a couple things that I need in this. I need labels, and I'm going to change this instead to something else, and you're going to see. So we're going to change, instead of 120,000, it's going to be 120K, for example. Paste in, divide this by 1,000, and replace it by K. Maybe it's like that. There we are. Now, after all that fiddling around, we got this going. So we replace that with 135K. So that looks pretty good. We can do that Y label And what are we going to call that? Let's just name it something simple. So let's call it sales total. And then this would be Great British Pounds. So we change that up. We can add a horizontal line for where the mean would be. That's going to be pretty simple. So do GOMH line. So it's going to be a horizontal line on the y-intercept where we're taking in the mean of our data, which will be the sales totals. And then I'm going to color this our trusty old red. So now we have a horizontal line of where the mean would be if you wanted that, for instance. So for any trolls that are still watching in the future, if you were saying, why didn't he create a bar chart? Why did he use a scatter plot? Because I was showing the basics of how you use a scatter plot. If you're calling in a bar chart, you would call in the same data, but you would instead call this right here, geom bar, stat identity. And this would give you your bar chart right here. Big old giant thing, right? And if you notice something, when I call in the increased plot size before from the previous cells, it's doing it for all the continuous cells now. Now, these data are interesting because you would use the options SciPen to remove all of the scientific notation. So let's look at something real quick. I think it might have, since I've already ran this, So this zoom in, there's your scientific notation right here. Okay, now should be taken care of unless you want something like that, but you take care of it using something like this. Then you call in your geom bar chart to create your bar chart, and then everything else that we did from the previous example could still be cut and pasted and placed in here after you change this. But since you're using by country instead of by description item, you just need to change this. So we could run that. And then you notice, okay, this is plotting pretty nicely, but it's doing it in alphabetical order. Maybe you don't want that. Maybe you want this in ascending or descending order for each one of these bars. So we can do an adjustment to this. So you just cut and paste everything else, but you have an addendum here, okay? And that's this line right here. So you're taking in and you're reordering. And if you notice this, we're doing descending order, all right? So we're taking in our category. And our category here, let me zoom out some, is these, right? And that's the only thing you do different, so you can reorder it in descending order, okay? And everything else is the same, cut and paste. I would like to say thank you for watching. Please like and subscribe. And if you subscribe, turn on that notification bell. I hope this brought utility to someone. Thank you for watching. I'll see you in the next video. Bye. Also, I'm considering doing a small video series for plotting in ggplot and possibly some plotting videos using Python. So let me know how you feel about that.